I'm back in the RV today, and I'm going to make some crispy chili beef. We're going to use almost a pound of stir-fry beef here. We're going to use one egg, 2 tablespoons of cornstarch. We're going to use our Asian five spice. We're going to use our chili garlic sauce, like 2 tablespoons of that. We're going to top it with some sesame seeds when we're done. We're going to use that ginger sweet chili sauce again from Food Lion. You can't beat it. Of course, Panda Express makes them, and La Choy makes some. There's a lot of different manufacturers out there. You can even get them at your international stores. But I use this one. We're going to use that today. We're going to put some crushed red pepper in our beef. We're going to put 1/8 teaspoon of cayenne. We're going to put 1/8 teaspoon of liquid smoke. We're going to use some red Thai chilies, 1 star anise, some spring onions and spring onion tops to top it with the sesame seeds at the end. A nice sweet red pepper. Of course, you can use a habanero, a serrano, a jalapeno. You can use any type of pepper you want. I'm going to dice that up really thin, the red pepper. And we're going to use some fresh garlic and some fresh ginger in this chili beef. Now, I'm going to use some soy sauce. Now, the other day I talked about the oils I use. When I'm cooking in the wok and I'm cooking on lower heat, I will use this light tasting olive oil. Only when I'm cooking on medium to low. If I'm cooking on medium, I tend to use this vegetable. If I'm cooking on higher heat in the wok, I'll use this canola oil instead of peanut oil or something else. I never use sesame oil in the wok. I do put it in the meat marinades and so forth, and I am going to put a couple jiggers in this meat, but I don't use it to actually fry with. Now, some alternatives to the chili sauce that I'm going to show you today. You can use regular chili powder if you don't have chili sauce. And that sambal chili sauce I usually use all the time, but I'm out of it right now. You can use hoisin sauce, fish sauce, oyster sauce. You can use some ground ginger. But you can also use some sweet hot mustard, and I have before in this very dish. So sometimes you have to make substitutions when you don't have certain ingredients. We're going to go ahead and get these vegetables cut up, and I'm going to show you the next step. We're also going to use some jasmine rice and our little Auticook cooker here that I showed you on the last video. I'll put the link down in the description for that little cooker. Now, it's only 800 watts. It works great on the inverter and the solar in the RV. I got my onions thinly sliced, my red pepper thinly sliced, the spring onion tops chopped up for the garnish. Got my garlic ready to micrograte, and I got my ginger skin back because we're going to micrograte that as well. So I cut that stir-fry beef down the center. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to micrograte some ginger in here. It's probably going to be about 1 teaspoon. I think that's good. Now we're going to micrograte this garlic in there as well. The whole garlic clove. Except for that outside there. Okay. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put 2 tablespoons of cornstarch in this meat. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to mix all that up. Massage that cornstarch, that garlic, and that ginger all into that meat. And then I'm going to add this egg. And this is only for me, so my hands are clean. So I got that little bit of cornstarch. Let me wash my hands here. And then we're going to add one more tablespoon of cornstarch. In that mixture. Massage that up a little bit. We're going to set this aside because we're going to fry this in some oil in the wok. But we're not quite done. We're going to add some red pepper flakes. We use a paper towel here. Wipe my hands. I'm going to add some red pepper flakes. Let me take the top off. Probably going to add a teaspoon. Red pepper flakes. You can use any pepper you want. And we're going to add we're only going to add 8. It's about 1/8 of a teaspoon of cayenne. That's 1/4 teaspoon. I only done about half. We're going to add that in there as well. Mix that up again. And we're going to set this aside and let it rest. So we're getting ready to fry it up. That's not the only heat ingredients I'm going to use, but that's what's going on the meat. All right, there you go. Now we're going to make our sauce. We're done with cornstarch. Set that aside. Now I'm going to take, I got 2 tablespoons of soy sauce in the measuring cup. And I'm going to take 2 tablespoons of this chili garlic sauce. Normally I would do the sambal chili sauce, chili paste, chili sauce. But I've got this chili sauce that I used in the char siu pork the other day. I've got that, so we're going to use that today. Now, we're going to add 1 tablespoon of Asian 5-spice. Let me rinse this measuring spoon. Actually, let me get a different one. I'm going to use 1 tablespoon. Well, that won't fit in there. We're going to do 2 1/2 tablespoon of Asian 5-spice. Set that aside. Now, I'm going to do 2 tablespoons of this ginger sweet chili sauce. Gonna do where's my 1/4 teaspoon? We're gonna do 1/4 teaspoon. Actually, I should do 1/8, so we're gonna do just a little bit of this liquid smoke. That that's going to be our sauce. We're going to give that a slight stir. And you'll see that it's quite thick. So it's going to end up coating the beef, the peppers, and the onions really well. There we go. We're going to set that aside, and I'll show you the next step. So in that meat, I meant to put a couple jiggers of sesame seed oil. Let me get a spoon here. I'm tired of washing my hands with that cornstarch on. Alright. A little bit of sesame seed oil for flavor. So we got our wok here. We're going to go ahead and heat the wok up. We're going to do it on medium. And to do these vegetables, I'm going to put a little water in the wok. Gonna bring that up to temperature. Okay, we're gonna put our chilies, our star anise. Just gonna let those hydrate a minute. Okay, those chilies been hydrating a little bit. We're gonna go ahead and add our onions and our peppers. Gonna cook these a little bit, get them translucent, the flavor of that star anise and that chili peppers in there. I'm gonna cook those for about 4 minutes or so, and we'll be back. I'm gonna evaporate most of that water out of there. I'm gonna turn it up a little bit. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and put these in this bowl and set it aside a minute. We're gonna add that back in. With the meat here in a minute. All right, we got a paper towel here. Get that moisture out of there. Alright, I'm going to turn my heat down just a little bit. And we're going to add some oil, probably about 4 tablespoons, give or take. I'm going to bring that up to temperature, and we're going to put our meat in there. We're going to go ahead and put this meat in here, just like this. Turn that burner up on high. We'll turn this fan off. All right, I think we're good. We're gonna add our sauce now and our vegetables. That all stirred up. These LED lights I put in this range hood, they don't do justice to the cooking food, to the food videos. All right, add our vegetables back in. I can't believe that wok didn't get hot as I wanted it. It's hot. That is unbelievable. That Asian five spice in that sauce is just unbelievable. Shut your burner off. We're gonna serve this up. Well, it's not quite as crispy as I'd like, but it's not bad. Let's throw a couple sesame seeds on top and our spring onions minced. I need some more light on the subject, don't I? There we go. Crispy chili beef. Let's give this a shot. Wow, it's got some heat. Put that cayenne. Woo! Let me grab a drink here. I put that cayenne, those red pepper flakes, the red Thai chilies, star anise, the Asian five spice. It's got a little kick. All right. You got to try that, but you got to make sure your wok's just a little hotter. So for Tom's Manly Meals, crispy chili beef. I'm Tom Moore. And you can cook in an RV. Good luck to you. Wow. That Asian five spice is unbelievable. And you can taste that star anise too. Somebody was good all the way through dinner, but now is wide awake. What are you doing?